Hi, Jason Tako. I hope you're all doing well. I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. I also want to give a special thanks to my subscribers. If you haven't yet subscribed, I encourage you to do so. It really helps me to continue making these videos, and you won't miss any of the upcoming episodes. Just wanted to mention a few things about this painting before we start the actual demonstration. The first one is that this was based on a charcoal drawing that was demonstrated on last week's video. If you haven't yet seen that video, I encourage you to do so. You'll see a little icon right above me right now. If you just click on that, that will take you to that video. Also, I'll have that at the end and the link in the description below in case you want to watch this video first before you watch the charcoal demonstration. I wanted to talk a little bit about the color in this painting. You'll notice in reference photo that it was photographed during the summer, green grass and blue skies. I didn't want that color scheme in this painting. I've been experimenting a lot with yellowish ochre tones and implying dust and everything. So that was a color scheme I decided to go with. You'll notice in this video that at one point I started experimenting with putting another rider back there in the right hand side. I felt that it might have needed something back there to add some interest, but after I put him in, I took a fresh look at it, didn't like it, so he came out. Don't be afraid to experiment with your paintings and try different things. When you do that though, it can be hard to judge whether something is good or not. Couple tricks that I use is I'll step away from it for a while, come back and look at it with a fresh eye. I'll also maybe look at some other artists' work that I really admire, not to copy them, but just to try to kind of reset my brain, if you will, so that when I go back and look at my painting, I can look at it with a hopefully a more objective viewpoint. Just be careful though that if you do look at other artists' work before you go back and look at your painting, try to leave a little bit of time and space between that so that you're not trying subjectively too hard to, like I said earlier, copy that other artist's work. Next thing I want to talk about is the technique in the edges. I went with the looser technique in this painting. I've been experimenting, trying to get looser with my work. I just like that look. Not that it's more superior to tighter work. It's just my own artistic preference. And the other thing is having looser edges and kind of messier edges, if you will, helps imply the feeling of motion. This is an action painting, and had I made everything really tight, I think it would have taken away from that feeling of movement. So if you want to imply movement and action in your work, focus on your edges. Don't make everything really perfect and really tight. That can imply, like I said, stiffness. Loosen them up, maybe even mess them up a little bit, and I think you'll be happy with the results if your objective is to imply action. So let's get started with the demonstration. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't done so already. Also hit that like button and leave any questions or comments you may have below. I love to hear your questions, hear your feedback. I love to know also if you like the time-lapsed approach, or if you would rather see just parts of the painting in regular time instead of having the whole thing sped up. So let me know in the comments below. I look forward to hearing from you and enjoy the demonstration.
Mm-hmm.